ईश्वरसमारम्भां नित्यानन्देश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। इस समय हमारे साथ उपस्थित सभी दर्शकों और भक्तों का मित्री एवं आशीर्वाद सहित स्वागत करो। आई वेलकम ऑल द डिवोटीज, डिसाइपल्स, समाजीज, सत्संगीज सिटिंग विद अस ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड एट दिस टाइम थ्रू Nityananda TV, Lotus TV, Janashree TV, Sadhana TV and through two-way video conferencing having been reached in 27 cities, you can preach in many cities around the world. The cities sitting with us all over the world, like Arunachalam, Devon, UK, Seattle, Chidambaram, Oklahoma, Somanatham, and Adiyamanam, Bangalore North,
Varkala, Kerala, Singapore, Singapuram, Singapore, Singapuram, Redondo Beach, California, Nityanandanagara, Bangalore, Houston, Kalahasti, Winnipeg, Canada, Temple Alwal, Secunderabad, நித்யானந்தநகரமு ஹைதராபாத், காட்மாண்டு நேபாள், ஓமன் சிவகங்கை, ஜோர்பாட்டு நேபாள், என்ரிச்சிங் டெம்பிள் பிடுதி, மொலியரஸ் பிரான்ஸ், கோலாலம்பூர் பழனி, டாலஸ் துவாரகா, சான் ஹோசே மதுரை, தேவோன் யூகே, லாஸ் ஏஞ்சலிஸ் அருணாச்சலம், ஒக்லஹாமா சோமநாதம். ஐ வெல்கம் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ with my love and blessings. Today I will expand on Kalpataru, causing enlightenment and few characters from Mahabharata. All the three together. The first few important truths, the sacred secrets you need to know. Biggest human suffering is self-doubt, self-denial, self-hatred. If I have to organize it one by one, self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial. First, it starts as self-doubt, flowers as self-hatred, becomes fruit in self-denial. That is the way step by step it moves. Please understand, the worst disease human beings suffer, I tell you, actually only after this self-doubt comes, God becomes human. Please understand, in this very land of Haridwar, from the time Ganga started flowing, one debate is going on. How God became human being? How the Akanda became Kanda? How the Paramatma became Jivatma? This debate is going on just like Ganga. The Dvaitis have their answer, Advaitis have their answer, Vishishtadvaitis have their answer, Atheists have their answer. Please understand, in Vedic tradition, atheism is also part of a philosophy. We respect atheists, but the moment you utter their name, even power goes away. Buddhists have their answers. Everyone has their answer. Please understand. Listen. I give you the experiential expression. not a philosophical intellectual answer, experiential answer. The experiential answer for this problem, how God became man, how Paramatma became Jivatma, how we got deluded ourselves into the moment self-doubt comes in, God becomes man. Macrocosm becomes microcosm. Paramatma becomes Jivatma. The first Maya, the origin of the Maya, the first delusion, first illusion is self-doubt. Please understand. If I erase at least few lakh people's self-doubt, help them to complete with their self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial, I'll feel my mission is achieved. I'll feel I accomplished for what I assumed human body. I'll feel my avataric mission is fulfilled. And today again I wanted to repeat, this should be Guru Vak for all my sannyasis, brahmacharis, devotees, disciples, followers. You will all take an oath. Constantly you will compete with your self-doubt, self-hatred and self-denial, and you will help. You will be cause for every human being to compete with their self-doubt, self-hatred and self-denial patterns. The biggest liberation you will experience on the planet Earth is being liberated from self-doubt, self-denial and self-hatred. Completion with self-doubt, self-denial and self-hatred will be the biggest, most powerful liberation you will experience. This Kalpataru Darshan itself is nothing but helping you to complete with your self-doubt, self-denial, self-hatred. Understand, self-doubt, self-denial, self-hatred is like a rock thrown on the head of the Kundalini snake. See, Kundalini is described as a sleeping snake in our root center, in our Muladhara. Self-hatred, self-doubt and self-denial is the huge rock thrown on that snake. What will happen? That snake cannot die, but it will fall into coma. It will fall into coma. Kalpataru is nothing but moving that rock out and slowly moving the Kundalini snake up. Actually, it is not a snake, don't be afraid. It is portrayed like a snake. when it wakes up, it moves like a snake through your spine and reaches your sahasrara, and the whole body flowers. Yesterday, one lady was complaining to me, in the cruise you told you will awaken my kundalini, and now you have to awaken. I did not experience. People have weird ideas. First thing, you have so much self-denial, that is why it becomes anger on me. You have to first complete with that. Second, when I awaken your kundalini, naturally it awakens. But you have your own expectation, you should jump, only then your kundalini is awakened. If that is the skill, then you jump, that's all. Anyhow, deep anger towards you, deep hatred towards you, deep self-denial should be completed. Only then, even if you awaken the kundalini, it can spread all over your body. Please understand, this Kalpataru Darshan is nothing but helping you to compete with your self-doubt. Actually, Vivekananda puts it very beautifully. Whether you meditate or do a kriya or do prayer or do a homa, do a yanya, go to a temple or go for tirtha yatra, you do any spiritual action or religious action, act, one part of your kundalini gets awakened and your prayers are answered. That is what is happening actually. You may use different names, homa, yanya, japa, puja, yoga, kriya, pranayama. You may use different names, but actually what is happening during that process, one amount of your kundalini, one quantity of your kundalini gets awakened, and that kundalini fulfills what you are asking for. That's exact science. Vivekananda puts it very beautifully. The concept I'm sharing with you now is from Vivekananda, Swami Vivekananda. Please understand, anything you want, you have the energy to express it, to make it into reality, to achieve it. If you just complete the self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial, if you complete with these three, simply the kundalini explodes and what you want is achieved. This whole Kalpataru Darshan is nothing but helping you to complete with your self-doubt, self-hatred and self-denial. I tell you, I take this up as a mission. From today, I declare, with integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching, this Kalpataru Darshan will always be made available wherever I go, free of cost. This is my commitment to the humanity. I see to it, everywhere people are helped with this knowledge, with this clarity, with this completion, with this process. I tell you, all your patterns, root patterns, the father of your root patterns, great-grandfather of your root patterns, great-grandmother of your root patterns, everything is your self-doubt, self-hatred, and self-denial. The moment you want something, you declare to yourself, you will not get it. If you have to get it, you will have to struggle, literally give your whole life to it. How many of you are able to cognize what I am saying? That is what exactly I call it, self-denial. Which is not true, please understand. Even though society makes you believe your self-denial is fact, it is not fact. All incarnations land on the planet Earth just to tell you this one truth. Your self-denial, your self-hatred, self-doubt is not truth or fact. That's all. That's all. You are more than what you believe as you. Because what you believe as you is framed by your self-denial, self-hatred, and self-doubt. No one can give you suffering. No one can take away what you want from your life. The great hope, the great truth, the greatest good news, which is truth, is you are not an ordinary being as you perceive because of your self-doubt, self-hatred, and self-denial. Complete all these three. Every child should be taught to complete with all these three, because these three patterns does not start in this birth. They come from the past birth inherited. Every child should be taught to complete with the self-doubt, self-hatred, and self-denial. This should be the responsibility of all my sannyasis, disciples, devotees, helping every human being to complete with this self-denial, self-doubt, and self-hatred. I tell you, as I was telling yesterday, Himalayas may be there, Ganga may be flowing, but if you are sleeping, what is the use? Without enjoying it. I can't even understand how people can miss. Himalayas may be there, Ganga may be there, but if you are sleeping, nothing can be done. What's the use? Life may be there, Guru may be there, but if you are stuck with a self-denial, nothing can be done. Self-denial is a powerful drug makes you powerless. That is the exact word I will use. Powerful drug makes you powerless. If you want to hate something, hate self-hatred. If you want to doubt something, doubt self-doubt. If you want to deny something in your life, deny self-denial. If you want to doubt, doubt self-doubt. If you want to hate, doubt self-hatred. Hate self-hatred. If you want to deny, deny self-denial. The direct enemy I have to deal in my life, in my avataric mission, is people's self-hatred, self-denial and self-doubt. Nothing else is my direct enemy. It's like when Rama comes down to planet Earth, Ravana, Kumbhakarna are the direct enemies. All other Vali and all is not direct enemy, side enemy. Vali was never a enemy of Rama and he was never against Rama. Actually, Vali would have been a better companion for Rama than Sugriva. Rama's mission is to get Sita back. Vali would have done it in 10 minutes. Because he used to play with Ravana. Ravana used to be afraid of Vali. Vali actually once brought Ravana as a play toy for Vali's son, Angada. That's why when Angada goes to Ravana's court, Ravana asks, "Who are you?" Then Angada says, "Touch your left cheek. There is a mark on your left cheek. Don't you remember? That is done by me. In my leg nail. When I was playing with you as my toy. I saw you once flying on the sky. I asked my dad, what is the 10-headed toy? Get me that. Do you remember? My dad got you as a toy and I was playing with you. Then your wife came and cried to my father. Then my father let you go. I also said, all right, I played with this toy enough. Please leave it." Vali would have got Ravana in 10 minutes. Anyhow, we do not know why Rama did what he did. That's different. All I am trying to convey through this example, the direct enemy is only Ravana and Kumbhakarna. Same way for Krishna. The direct enemy was only Gamsa and Shishubala. Duryodhana was not his enemy. I tell you, the direct enemy for me in this incarnation is people's self-doubt, self-hatred and self-denial. Nothing else is a direct enemy for me. The self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial of the human beings is my direct enemy. I will complete them. That's my mission. Every human being should be taught the science of completing with self-doubt, self-hatred and self-denial. When you start working on this, completing with self-doubt, self-hatred and self-denial, so much of Kundalini energy awakens, that energy will automatically guide you to create what you want, achieve what you want. That energy will automatically liberate you, lead you to ultimate enlightenment. In my temples, only three demons will be portrayed. That is self-doubt, self-hatred and self-denial. People should complete with these three and only then enter my temple. only then you can enter into the space of divine. Please understand, all hatred you have with others is hatred which is there in you, about you. All doubt you have about others is nothing but the doubt you have in you. All denial you have about others is nothing but the denial you have about you inside. Complete these three inside, you will see suddenly the world will be different for you. I am not saying world will become different for everyone, it will become different for you. Because ultimately, you create your world. You create your world. Self-hatred. Naturally creates hatred about you everywhere. Self-doubt naturally creates doubt about others in you, in others about you. Self-denial naturally makes you deny others, others you. That is the source of all sufferings. That is the source of all bad things. Whatever may be the purpose of your life, good or bad, health or wealth, the self-hatred, self-denial, self-doubt should be completed with every desire. If I just help you to complete your self-doubt, the desire become reality in your life. Actually, I am not giving you any boon other than helping you to complete that self-doubt, that's all. I use various methods, sometimes by giving knowledge. Sometimes even if I tell you won't listen, I just infuse energy into that and blast that self-doubt like a balloon. That's what I call initiation. I use various methods, but finally process is the same. And I commit with you all, I'll share this science and this Kalpataru Darshan with the whole world forever, free of cost. Because this is the most important mission, part of my life. Please understand, if you see Mahabharata, every action of Dhritarashtra is self-doubt. Every action of Shaguni is self-hatred. This Shaguni does not even understand he is destroying the same family where his own sister is married. So much of self-hatred. Every action of Duryodhana is self-denial. Please listen. Self-denial is born from self-doubt and assisted by self-hatred. Born from Dhritarashtra, assisted by Shaguni. Self-denial is born from self-doubt, assisted by self-hatred. As I said, Bhishma is Dharma, embodiment of Dharma. But unfortunately, even Dharma, If it joins hands with a self-denial, it will not be able to save self-denial and it will destroy itself. So the only person who can destroy self-denial is an incarnation, Krishna. Bhagavan Krishna. Only he can destroy the self-denial, self-hatred and self-doubt. Self-doubt is blind. Self-hatred is cunning. Self-denial is stupid. Understand? Self-doubt is blind. Doesn't know what is there in front, like Dhritarashtra. Self-hatred is cunning. Does not even know he is harming his own sister, means himself. Self-denial is stupid. Throughout Duryodhana's life, you see, all his actions are stupid. Many times knowing he cannot win, he is not going to win, he behaves stupidly. Otherwise, will this stupid order arrest of Krishna? I tell you, the good news I have for all of you is this self-doubt, self-hatred and self-denial can be completed. Just because you have all three of them, you don't need to get destroyed. There's no need that you should be destroyed, no. You can be completed, it can be completed. You can achieve completion. You can reach completion. That's the good news I have. Whatever may be your purpose, whether you are going to be a doctor to heal others, or you are going to be in the army to kill others, you are going to practice law or accounts or engineering or architecture, are going to live a life of a housewife, are going to be retired, waiting for death, whatever may be your life, please complete with your self-doubt, self-hatred and self-denial, you will have a great life in front of you. You will have a great possibility in front of you. All the great truths you will be able to grasp in your life and implement them. See, many people say, oh, these are all too big ideas, I cannot grasp, this is going above my head. When I talk about integrity, they say, no, it's going above my head, I am tired, I cannot. These are all for some serious people. Understand? Your self-doubt will never allow you to grasp the science of life. It will never allow you to grasp the science of life. Either it will show things are above your head, or it will make you doubt the same guy who is teaching you the spirituality. I have seen people have doubt, why is he wearing this gold pin on the head? It is not gold, first of all, you need to know that. Even if it is, that is not going to affect me in any way. It may affect you, but not me. this SDHD means self doubt hatred denial. I'll call it as SDHD. One of my disciple Moksha Priyan has sent a message. Let us call this as SDHD, Swamiji. It's right.
Yeah.
The greatest disease that the whole world is suffering is SDHD.
Yeah.
And the cure for this is Kalpataru Darshan. Like ADHD, SDHD. Self-doubt, hatred, denial. I have decided, I will popularize this word. Moksha Priyan is the inventor of this word. SDHD. Moksha Priyan, first you have to cure this SDHD. Yourself. Because the inventor cannot be suffering with the same disease. SDHD is the right word. I tell you, this is the right word. My mission is to cure the world from SDHD. Self-doubt, hatred, denial. The vaccine for SDHD is Gurukul. Cure for SDHD is Kalpataru Darshan. Gurukul is the vaccination for SDHD. Kalpataru Darshan is the cure for SDHD. We will put a board in all our ashram. Here we cure SDHD. Every day morning, cure for SDHD will be available. 8 to 9, contact here. Now this is one of the worst disease human beings are suffering. See, the problem is, this Saguni fellow, he thinks he is very intelligent, but he doesn't know. Now the self-hatred thinks he is very intelligent, he can control everyone and manipulate everyone. But finally, he doesn't know, he is only destroying himself. Every problem human beings suffering, human beings are suffering is from SDHD. Self-doubt, hatred, denial. SDHD. What a great invention, SDHD. January 3rd is the day we invented SDHD. And the cure for it. I'll lead you all into the Kalpataru process. Please sit straight. Again. Create a space for what you want to achieve in your life. Means, consciously, responsibly visualize what you want in your life and declare it is already reality. And all the SDHD comes up. Self-doubt, hatred, denial comes up during this process. Declare completion with it. Desire to complete it. Hold on to the space to create what you want as reality. Please close your eyes. Sit straight. Create responsibly what you want. Responsibility, complete with all the SDHD, self-doubt, hatred, denial comes up.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.